This is David here, and this is my final video on the topic of the video game Watch Dogs, which I played on my PlayStation 3. And so I talked a bit about the mechanics and about how my opinion on how I think Aiden Pierce, the main character that you play as, is a sociopath, quite possibly a psychopath, fitting the clinical definition of it, and not necessarily the casual term that people use. Because people say, oh, he's a psychopath, you know, meaning like, and he's an asshole or something. But the clinical definition of psychopath is not that. It's actually somebody who cannot feel guilt, who doesn't have the emotional capacity to feel remorse and guilt. So it's kind of the mental wiring. It's a very psychological and sociological kind of phenomenon that happens. Condition, actually, I suppose, that's possible. So a sociopathic or psychopathic individual doesn't necessarily mean somebody who's going to murder you and who's going to, you know, do bad things to you. Psychopaths can be very successful in society. You can be a neurosurgeon and be a psychopath. You can actually even win a Nobel Peace Prize and possibly be a psychopath because you have the mental capacity to figure out what is right and wrong, logically speaking, and what actions will be encouraging peace. What kind of social interactions you should have with other people to encourage peaceful dialogues. You can have that capacity. You just don't have the capacity to feel guilt. That is a psychopath, and I think Aiden Pierce is that. Not a psychopath personally, but I think he's more a sociopath. Although I'm not sure about psychopath. I think he very well could be a psychopath. Anyway, all that aside, another thing that, you know, is a talking point about this game is, of course, the ability to use your phone and hack into stuff. And the biggest thing is the profiler, right? Aiden Pierce is not the best hacker according to the storyline, and I would agree. You know, he meets with this other character who's like the original hacker genius who can create a virus. Aiden Pierce's hacking skills, according to the story, is not up to that level. But he has created this thing, and he can hack into the central operating system that pretty much operates and runs Chicago. He can access certain parts of it with his phone. I think the spoof script really made fun of this. Like, this makes no sense. This is not possible. It's not feasible that this is how it works. The fact that, and even Clueless Gamer, Conan O'Brien made the point like, wait, this one city is utilizing one central operating system to maintain everything that goes on in the city? And he brings out an IT expert like, do you think this is a good idea? You don't really need to be an IT expert to answer that. No, this is a horrible idea because there are hackers like Aiden Pierce who can hack into the system and wreak havoc. Absolutely right. But that's the premise of the game. And you're able to press the square button on the PlayStation 3 controller. It would probably be the X button on the Xbox 360 or whatever buttons that the PS4 and Xbox One uses. I'm not sure. And the Wii U also, I think there's a Wii U version of the Watch Dogs as well. And PC, who knows? People probably hook up a controller for the PC version of this game. But the square button, you press to able to enable your profiler. And this was, I thought, was one of the most fascinating things. And I think other than, you know, watching Aiden Pierce interacts, you know, controlling practically a psychopath was very, uncomfortable yet compelling at the same time to me. It's not a feeling that I normally feel with a lot of the other games. That's what made the experience of Watch Dogs kind of unique to me. But the other part was the profiler thing. I was actually quite surprised. So every time you kind of walk by a person, you can use a profiler and you look in his direction. Profiler would tell you the person's name, occupation, a little secret detail about the person, like, oh, this person goes to the Rocket Club every Sunday, or this person is unemployed. This person has cheated on his wife. Has little details like that, I think, which is also kind of mind-boggling that a you know, a phone algorithm hacking thing that you develop can automatically, without Aiden's peer's input, which is impossible, input, kind of dig up and just kind of be like, oh, this is an interesting tidbit that you might find interesting about this person, such as this person is in the mafia, things like that. And then and then below that or above that, there's a detail about the amount of money this person makes, the person's income. Because you can hack into certain people, their bank account, and steal money from them that way. And so that's also the kind of the moral test that this game has for the player. There's absolutely no consequences whatsoever if you decide to hack a person's and steal their bank account. Like, there's no consequences. You don't really get caught. Your wanted level does not go up. You know, you can just do it whatever. If you want to, you can do it, because Aiden Pierce has that power to do it. So whether you want to or not is entirely up to you. And of course, people who are playing the game in a more game mechanic-y way, like people who are like, oh, this is a video game, I need as much money as I need to buy all the weapons I want, to buy all the clothes I need. You know, people like with that mindset are just probably going to be hacking as many people as possible. With me, I found myself a bit more like in kind of a more emotionally conflicting pieces. But it's an interesting interaction, like engagement with characters. Like, wait, so this, you know, secret blurb about this person. This person has cancer. You know, it's like, wait, oh, does that automatically make me want to, you know, refrain from hacking into this person's bank account? But then that makes you think, well, what about all these other people that I've, like, just hacked the bank account into? Like, what, just because that little blurb doesn't really tell me about themselves, that I'm not doing. So this is why, like, playing as Aiden Pierce, a sociopath, is so interesting. Because Aiden Pierce would definitely think this way, in a more logical way. Like, oh yeah, you know, the thing down that I'm doing as a hacker is a really important cause. And he gets to make decisions like that. Like, he makes $80,000 a year. So if I steal $1,000 from him, that is not actually wrong, because I can use that $1,000 to purchase weapons to save my sister, which is the logic that goes around if you are a sociopath and you can't feel guilt for whatever consequences that happen, because you think that way. You're logically able to think in this very intellectual way without the impact of moral, emotional conscience. But I'm playing it in a way I'm just like, holy crap, you know, even besides all that, hacking into someone's bank account, getting their private information, details about their name, who they are, all that is, like, morally problematic, ethically wrong. Like, not morally, but ethical. This is an issue of ethics, and Aiden Pierce throughout the game is just violating all kinds of ethics every single second, every single minute that you control him. So just being able to access that data about people around you is crazy, you know. But you're hacking into people, and that was just like a kind of a really interesting exercise that I also had. That was also a very uncomfortable yet compelling part about Watch Dogs for me, the profiler aspect of it. And it's actually pretty remarkable what I thought was how they incorporated the professions that these people have and the income that they have. I walked by somebody with the profession social worker. You know, I'm in a graduate school training to be a social worker. I have a bachelor's degree in social work. I've done, after a bachelor's degree, I've worked at a homeless shelter, so I was kind of working in the social services field for a while. So there is this person in video game universe who is a social worker. And I'm like, whoa, wait, well, that's intriguing. And I look at the income, and the income is $44,000 or something like that. I think I ran into another social worker who was $56,000. That was amazing to me, because that actually is the median income of social workers in the United States, around $45,000 to $55,000. So, whoever, you know, the game makers of Watch Dogs was careful to utilize kind of the actual figures for median and mean income of professions, and they incorporated that into this game, which I thought was quite amazing. And they also broke one of the stereotypes too, because I encountered a person who was, his profession was unemployed, but he had an income. And that's when I don't think many people realize that actually that's unemployed doesn't necessarily mean not having an income for a certain segment of the population. So the fact that they were able to kind of include all these kind of things into it. Their professions really matched up with their income levels, and I gotta commend Ubisoft for that. I think they did the quite a fantastic job of the realistic portrayal of incomes and the profession that they're in the context of it being in Chicago in the near future. So pretty remarkable, I thought, just the whole profiler aspect. And there are actually levels, so I'll probably have another video on Watch Dogs, actually, talking more about kind of the interesting level design that is only possible in Watch Dogs because of the hacking mechanic that makes it, distinguishes it from all other open world games. So that'll be the next video.